I've just cut some Swiss chard from the NFT system, which has been out there for, basically I put that one in when I moved the NFT system around. And this is the second time I've eaten it for tea, and I just went out and picked some for my dinner. I'll put the margarine and a butter knife next to it to give you some perspective. But that's grown as well as anything that I've ever grown in dirt, so I'm quite impressed by that. If you remember a while ago, we regenerated a stick, which was a broken cherry tomato that was in the little mist cloner. This is the little cherry tomato now, and this is the root growth on it in the NFT system. It's just remarkable what this thing has done. Considering that this was just a stick, it was totally dead, and we brought it back to life, I think we've done pretty well with this one. In the back here, behind the cherry tomato, I'll just turn it around so we can get a better look at some stuff. You may remember that this little pepper plant was one that we regenerated in the little cloner as well. It's doing quite nicely. What I've got here is just a 2-inch pot with the same foam suspension media. The roots have now grown to the point where I have trouble tucking them back in here, but that one's going fine. This little tomato here was generated from a cutting in the little cloner. It's the same thing. It's just got foam suspension. This one here's another little tomato plant with the foam suspension from the cloner. You can see how much the roots have grown on it. That one came out 10 days ago and was put in here, put in the NFT system. While I'm at it, I'll show you one of the lettuces down in one of the deep water culture buckets. I mean, that's the size of the top of a deep water culture bucket, a 5-gallon bucket. That's a 4-gallon bucket actually. And that's not a bad lettuce to grow in a little 3-inch pot at the top of it. So that's a pepper plant next to it. It's nearly as, well, in fact, it's bigger than the pepper plant. Just thought I'd give you a look at how I'm changing over how I'm adding to the nutrients now. What I've done is I've got a little square 12 litre bucket. Might be 15, it looks like about a 12. And I got a $4 tap to put in the front of it. I made a mistake in putting the tap in the middle. I should have put it off to one side, but basically all I've got is a metre of hose. I can mix up my nutrients in here. Well, what I'm doing is I'm adding a Campbell's tomato mix on one day, and then I wait till the next day till I add the calcium nitrate. At the moment this is a batch of calcium nitrate going in. I just tip it in the top of the bucket, mix it, and I can watch it easily till it's dissolved. Then I turn on the tap, and the tap flows into the top of the reservoir. Saves me getting down and underneath the NFT system and doing stuff in a cramped position. It's just a mile easier. I can mix it over on the bench and then just bring it in, put the hose in, and away we go. It's only a metre of hose, and it's proved to work very well. Tomatoes seem to be liking it, because if I just zoom in on there, you can see that there's plenty of tomatoes forming on that that ox heart there. They're not ready to ripen yet, they're only half grown, but like they'll do okay. Time for a look at the square cloner now that it's Boxing Day. I'm going to lift it up. We've got a temperature of 26 degrees in the big cloner, get over there and we'll have a look. Okay, over there we've got roots everywhere off that one. 2, 3, so we got 4 success. This one's rotted. This one is definitely shooting, but not shooting very well. So we've got 4.5. That's pretty good. Interesting that we got one that rotted in here though. Oops, get the lid back on. Okay, just move over to the small cleaner, little round one, and see what we got in there. I'll disconnect it from the mist maker, because otherwise it'll be too foggy to see what's going on. Okay, so we've got one here with plenty of roots. That one's got none. 2 with plenty of roots. A third one with plenty of roots. A fourth one with plenty of roots. And a fifth one just starting to shoot. And this one didn't shoot at all. So that's how we went on the little cleaner. So the results would appear to be, at the end of it, they were pretty much equal. But like, we had one rotted, and we had 4 good shoots and 1 poor one on each of the cloners, so no real difference. But I've just put the temperature, the thermometer into the small one. That temperature has shot straight up to 36 degrees, so the little one is definitely running 10 degrees hotter than the big square one. The big square one definitely produced roots before the little one, so I've got to conclude that temperature is a big factor in this. The way in which the small one uses the mist is quite good, but it works much better when it's cold weather.